And welcome to Wise Link Academy. For today, we're going to be drawing a parabola using what we called the rectangular method and the dot. First things first, let's read out the question. The question says, draw a parabola with its axis vertical in a rectangular 1 to 8 millimeter height by 114 millimeter wide. So your first task here, my first priority is to draw horizontal and vertical line. So to draw that successfully, my first task here is to what? Draw horizontal line. Let's say take it start from here. Horizontal line. The faint horizontal line. Let me extend it downwards this way. Right, next up, I need a vertical line, which I'll use my T-square, or perhaps Z-square rather, to draw upward. So I have this. Now at this point, this is my horizontal and then vertical line. So I'm told that the height is given to be 1 to 8 millimeter. That's 12.8. So I'll measure out 12.8. From here, this is 0. To this point is 12.8. 5, 6, 7, 8, 12.8 to this point. Next up, the width, or perhaps the wideness of the parabola, is given to be 114 millimeter wide. That's 11.4. So 11.4 at this point. So with the help of those 2 points, I'll create out a rectangle. So I will extend this point upward, and then I'll close it up using this point I have here. So I have this rectangle. So with this rectangle, I can easily produce out a box, right? So how do I do that? My first act is that I will divide the width by 8. I will divide the height by 4. If I divide this by 6, divide it by 3. That's the concept. So I will divide this by, let me use 8, right? Or perhaps, let's use 8. Or perhaps 6. You could use 6 and yet 3. So if I decide, let's use 8, right? So I will take my compass, right? At any convenient radius, right? I will come to this point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's all. Next up, the same thing I did here. I'll come to this, we call this the line division method, right? Extend it this way at any convenient angle you want. You can do it this way too, at any convenient angle you want. With the same distance you have used from here to here, take it 1, 2, 3, 4. Since you divided by 8, divided by 4. Now, how do you join them together? First things first, I will use this one to join this to the edge point here. You can see, so let me get it back to the edge point here. Hold this down, right? I'll hold this down. I'll take this man here. I'll place it beside this way, so I can what? Slide down. So take this together. I'll join this. Can you see that? I'll join this. Observe. And also, I'll join the last one, which is this, together. Right, I have this. Next up, with the help of those points, take this down with a faint line. Take it, this one, down with a faint line. And take this down with a faint line. This is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm done. My next task now is to what I did here. I'll do it here too. I will join the longest part together. If I join this part and this part together this way, right, and I'll place this guy at this part here, then I will start sliding. So I have this. I'll start sliding to have a parallel line. That's one of the benefits of placing your 45 degree and 60 degree set square this way, to maintain a parallel line between this line, right? And this line division method helps to divide line evenly, right? So it helps divide line equally. So I've done that successfully. Next task is to take this point upwards. I'll take this man upward. I'll take this man here too, upward. Take this one too, upward. Take this one too, upward. Take this upward. I'll take this upward. I will also finally take this upward. So after slowly what divide this as we decided to do, right? So what's my next task? My next task now is that, observe please, this is center, call this 0 and call this 1 2 3. Please observe the numbering. Call this 1 2 3 4, right? Next up, I'll call this 1, I'll call this 2, I'll call this 3, and I'll call this 4. The same way, here to be 1, since here is 2, here becomes 2, 3, here becomes 3, 4, here becomes 4. Right? So, with the help of those points, I will join them to the center this way. Right? I'll join to center. Center 1. Center to 3, center here, point 0 to touch point 2, point 0 to touch point 1, this way, the same way, that's from my left hand side. From my right hand side, point 0 to touch point 4, point 3 to touch point 0, point 2 to touch point 0, finally point 1 to touch 0.0. So I have all this. So what's my next procedure? My next task here is that I need to start reading points. This is line 1. So line 1 touches 1 at this point. This is line 1 touching 1 at this point. I'm done. Next up, line 2 touching 2. Line 2 touching 2. Line 2 touching 2, sorry, line 2 touches 2. This is not 2, please. This is 3. It's a mistake. Line 2 touches 2 at this point. Line 2 touches 2. Line 2 touches 2 at this point. Line 3 touches 3 at this point. Line 3 touches 3 at this point. Line 4 touches 4, touches 4 at this point. So I'll use my French curve to join points together. So if I take this one this way, observe, I'll take this one this way. I take this one this way. I can easily join this, right? So I can just take this one this way and join this to this. Next up, with the help of my French curve this way, I'll join 3 points together. I have this. You can see that. The same way, I'll take this 4, we join it together with those points. See? So I have this. So this is a parabola using what we called the rectangular method.